This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, gosh, have we got a dish for you. Go Providence brings us the folks from Vanity and the Thirsty Beaver. Chef Andrea joins us today to make what?
Beer-baked mac and cheese.
That's right. Beer and mac and cheese all compiled into one dish. Pretty simple, familiar ingredients for a lot of folks at home. What are we using today?
We have a larger egg or a larger shell pasta. You can use elbow pasta, whatever you like. Ground mustard. We have a Sam Adams beer, heavy cream, milk, butter, salt, pepper, panko, breadcrumbs, and then into the cheeses we have grated Romano, brie, a sharp cheddar, and Gouda.
I think that's what really jazzes up something like mac and cheese. It's a comfort food for a lot of people at home. It's a staple for a lot of kids, too. So you can put a fun twist on this by incorporating a combination of cheeses, right?
Yeah, yep. And with the Gouda goes really well with the beer, and the brie smooths it out a little bit for you.
The beer, we have to get to that, too. You made a suggestion of what not to use, too, right? Because, I mean, if you have beer lying in your fridge, grab a bottle, but make sure it's the right kind. What
yeah,
should you use?
You don't want to go with a light beer. You're really not going to get much flavor out of it. And if you go with a porter, then it's going to be a little too bitter for it. You're going to get the sharpness out of the cheddar, so you want to stay away from like a porter and a light beer, so stick with something in the middle, like a lager and stuff. So Sam Adams, Newcastle, things like that work really well for it.
Okay, great. Get all your ingredients ready because we're going to start cooking in just a bit.
Thanks, Brendan. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Go Providence has brought a Chef Andrea, Vanity, Thirsty Beaver, and we got mac and cheese. Not just any mac and cheese, we got beer-baked mac and cheese.
Yeah.
All right, what are we going to do?
All right, so we started with a little bit of butter in the pot. You can actually add the beer right to it.
All right, pour this in.
Yep.
Get a little sizzle. There we go.
From there, you're going to add, I've mixed heavy cream and some milk together.
Okay. Should I be whisking this while we're putting this in?
No, it doesn't matter.
It's cool? Okay. Let's put this in here.
And then a little bit of pepper in there.
Okay. Some of this. Good. Are you going a little more?
A little bit more.
A little more? All right. Okay.
All right. And now you're going to add your brie into it first.
This one right here?
Yep,
okay.
That one right there.
Sorry.
I've taken the rind off of it so that it doesn't, it's a little harder so it won't melt in it as fast.
So. Okay, so this is easy. It'll melt quicker this way.
Yeah.
Okay. Put some of this in here. All right, got it.
Yep, and then we're gonna add all the rest of the cheese to it.
Okay. So put this. What kind of cheese is this one here?
That one's the smoked Gouda.
Okay.
And
this here.
That is the sharp cheddar.
All right. Get this in here, and then whisk this all together.
Yep. And then you're just gonna mix it up and let everything melt.
Okay. All right. So this is a great, great cheese sauce to put mix in with the macaroni itself, right?
Yeah.
And what kind of beer did you use for this?
I used Sam Adams in this one.
Okay. Now, because you have that Gouda in there, it doesn't seem to melt as easy as the other two cheeses that we put in. How high do we have to run this at?
Right now I have it on high just so that it starts to get hot. You want to turn it down to about medium high so that it doesn't burn on the bottom of it, and you obviously want to keep mixing it. And as the cheese melts, it'll thicken up
It'll thicken up too.
Yep.
Okay, is this one of the newer things on the menu, or if this is one of the most popular
This is going to be something new, where Thirsty Beaver is actually going on its one-year anniversary and around St. Patrick's Day, so we're looking to kind of bring something new to the menu and stuff. Yeah.
All right, this is perfect. If you like mac and cheese, you never want to get it out of the box, this is the best way to make it.
Yep.
I'm going to put that macaroni in there, the shells in there, cook those for just a little while, and then mix this together, and you can already smell the beer in here. It smells great. Back to you. Go Providence has brought us in Chef Andrea from Vanity and the Thirsty Beaver. Mm-hmm. We've got mac and cheese that just is...
Oh, not just any mac and cheese,
beer. Beer mac and
beer
cheese.
Beer baked.
Beer baked mac and cheese. And man, woo, it's good. All right.
Bring us up to speed now, because in the last segment, you and Will were working on the cheese sauce.
Sure. I was letting it go a little bit just to thicken it up a little bit. It is still a little loose, but it will thicken as it bakes a little bit more when it absorbs into the pasta.
Right.
So that can go right into the...
So you're just going to take this, put it in here, right?
Yeah, however you feel comfortable.
Do you have to spray it?
No, you don't have to.
No? Or do you want to just dump it in, or do you want to just ladle this in?
I can dump it.
Go ahead and ladle. Yeah, you got it. You're using the shells, too, which I love when you're, whether you have sauce or mac and cheese, they hold so much more because of that shell shape.
Yeah. It definitely works well. Again, you can use, like, an elbow macaroni or a corkscrew pasta.
Wow.
Whoa.
That looks good. And this is something new that you're bringing to the menu.
Yep, something new. And here we have panko breadcrumbs and some Romano, and that can go right on top. Sprinkle it, and it's going to go in the oven and bake at 375 for about 20 to 25 minutes.
So when this comes out, it's going to be nice and crispy on top.
Yep, it'll be nice and crispy on top.
Beautiful. And you had a combination of cheeses that went into it, not just on top.
Yeah, we had, it was Gouda, sharp cheddar, brie, as well as grated Romano cheese.
Yum.
So that'll go in the oven.
So
that's
going to get a nice color on top, too, that combination of cheese and breadcrumbs.
Oh, man. Yeah. Wow, look at this.
You took a sneak peek?
Yeah. Here it is.
Wow.
That looks fantastic.
Now that's mac and cheese.
Ooh.
And then
nice
to go with it, we have, it's called the Big Bad Wolf. It is Bacardi Wolfberry with lemonade, Sprite with bitters on top. And, so definitely join us March 30th. We have the Disney brunch at Vanity, and Thirsty Beaver, we're going on our one-year anniversary.
Very nice.
Yeah, we said right around St. Patty's Day is when the anniversary lies.
Okay, so let's talk about the Thirsty Beaver itself. Give us the where it is and...
Sure, it's on Atwood Ave, down closer to St. Mary's Church, down that way.
Okay.
We're all right over there.
All right.
It's a great place. So you walk in, and it's log cabin-esque. You feel like you've gone to a different state.
Yeah, definitely. It's a lot of fun. It definitely bring the family down. It's fun at night and on the weekends and things like that. So.
All right.
And always a
we have this here. Let's dig in.
Here you go.
Let's dig in. Let's see what we've got
here. That's not for you to eat with.
No.
Well, that's just a scoop of plate.
Right, so I'm going to scoop this out.
I'll get you a fork.
Some of the
same. Andrew, how often are you thinking up new combinations of things and putting a new twist on an old classic like this for the restaurant?
Quite often. I mean, something different for everybody to try and things like that. Mm-hmm. So it should be fun. But again, like I said, with the 1 year anniversary coming up, we're trying to put some fun things out there. So.
All right, this is really, really hot.
It is really hot.
Give it the test.
Mmm. That's good.
Good.
And I love the breadcrumbs on top.
Yeah. You can hear it crunching. That's a good sign.
Oh my God, it's perfect.
It's a good sign of a mac and cheese.
It really is. It's so good.
What other specialties are on the menu at both places, Vanity and Thirsty Beaver?
Vanity, obviously, like their Italian egg rolls are a big seller for them. With Thirsty Beaver, pizzas, chicken wings, things like that. Again, we're going to try and play it up and create a fun couple new entrees and everything for everyone to try, as well as some appetizers that people haven't seen yet. So
even if you've been there before, you're going to want to keep stopping
keep
in.
Shopping.
Every so often,
yeah,
make
every
sure you
so
keep
often.
Up with the menu there and have at it, Will. Go ahead.
Oh, man, I'm telling you.
I'll scoop myself a plate
if
in a
you are used to having, like, the mac and cheese out of a box or something like that, this is like a whole other world.
It is.
You're not doing it right. All right, if you want to try this recipe, head on over to WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.